Cholangiocarcinoma is a devastating cancer which affects the bile ducts. It is unfortunately rising in incidence throughout the world and accounts for approximately 15% of all liver cancers. It's often associated with inflammation of the bile ducts, but in some cases, no cause is known. The ideal treatment for cholangiocarcinoma is surgical removal. Unfortunately, it often presents at a stage where that is not an option. Cholangiocarcinoma doesn't respond to chemotherapy, and this contributes to the terrible survival rate, which is 5% at 5 years. In other words, only 1 in 20 people who present with a disease will currently be alive in 5 years' time. The purpose of this study is to understand which are the drivers of growth of the cancer. If we understand which signals cause a tumour to grow, we can hopefully then develop new treatments for the tumour. We noticed that all of the cholangiocarcinomas were surrounded by a large number of cells called macrophages. Macrophages are cells with many roles in the body. They help to fight infection, but importantly, they're also involved in the repair of damaged tissue. It is known that in the development of cancers, macrophages can also supply signals which can drive the growth of those tumours. Macrophages express many factors, including one we call Wnt. And Wnt helps tissues to repair themselves following injury, but it also can be involved in driving the development of cancers. We therefore decided to look at whether macrophages and a signal they supply, Wnt, is involved in driving the growth of cholangiocarcinoma. We analysed tissue from a large number of patients with cholangiocarcinoma, and what we found was that the Wnt signalling pathway was highly upregulated in the cancer areas compared to the non-cancer areas. We looked in the tissue in detail and we found that Wnt ligands were often expressed by the tissue-associated macrophages.
So we developed two models of cholangiocarcinoma, one in mice and one in rats. This allows us to look at the development of the disease as well as the cancer forming in these animals. We used these models because they really closely resemble how human disease develops and how cancer then forms. When we look at the precancerous disease, we can see the biliary epithelial cells in green. They express a core protein from the Wnt pathway, beta-catenin, here in red. And only when those biliary epithelial cells become cancerous do we see the beta-catenin moving into the nucleus, which comes up as pink. After the tumours have developed for 20 weeks, we see another molecule in the Wnt pathway, Wnt7b, increasing. So this further suggests that the Wnt pathway is important in how cholangiocarcinomas grow. When we stained the cholangiocarcinomas in the rat for Wnt7b here in green and the macrophage marker CD68 in red, we found two types of expression. The first was in macrophages and the second was bound to the epithelium in those cancers. Again, highlighting the fact that this signalling pathway might have a very important role in how these tumours develop and grow. So we wanted to investigate whether macrophages were the source of Wnt ligand during tumour development in the rat. To do this, we deleted macrophages with a chemical called liposomal clodronate and found that as we reduced the number of macrophages, the amount of Wnt7b being expressed also reduced. When we delete macrophages, we find that the size of the tumours are reduced, but also the number of tumours throughout the whole liver is reduced. What we found was that a large number of genes associated with the Wnt signalling pathway are also turned down. Deleting macrophages in human cancers wouldn't be a therapeutic option. What we've tried is giving small molecules to inhibit the Wnt pathway to see whether we can elicit the same reduction in cancer in our rats that we see when we deplete the macrophages. We've used two small molecule Wnt inhibitors, ICG001 and C59, which target two distinct parts of the Wnt pathway and are both being used for clinical trials in other tumours. When we treated rats with either of these inhibitors whilst they were developing cholangiocarcinoma, we found there was a reduction in both the size and number of the tumours in the liver.
We're very excited by these results, because Wnt inhibitors have been used in patients with other forms of cancer. What we'd like to do now is test such experimental drugs in our patients with cholangiocarcinoma. If we can find a positive benefit, we can develop potentially a new treatment for patients with cholangiocarcinoma, currently a devastating disease with very few treatment options.